told them, now listen, if you want me to be national team, give me 3 years to work. I give me a couple of years to keep the game back. Because table tennis, when I was in Nigeria, I was putting it in a higher level.
Yes.
Now it's very down.
That's right.
Down.
You know, I was sharing with somebody that some presidents like Sean Ekong and other people that today you don't even hear their name.
Exactly.
But I just went to Nigeria, I just came back from Nigeria a few weeks ago, and you're still hearing the name Atanda Musa.
Nah.
So we know you are a legend.
Yes,
and now people need to know that.
Thank you.
I grew up hearing the name Atanda Musa.
Yeah.
Not even when you relate to Tokyo, if you are agile or you do something unbelievable,
that's
people
right.
say Atanda Musa.
Yes,
and
yes,
you're wondering,
yes.
who is this Atanda Musa? Why is his name so popular?
That's right.
Yes. You know?
Because during that time in Tokyo, Nigeria, we make the game so
popular.
So rest in peace, remember that was a very good player. Oh, he's there? He's
there now.
Very good player. When I want to play this guy, it's like I want to give Tom Graham out. This guy is so talented that you know what we want to deal with this guy. If I want to deal with this guy, it's not an easy way. It's going to be like 4-3-2, 4-3-21-19.
Whoa!
No, I'm serious. 4-3-21-19. This guy is stupid in everything. You fight for a car in 1982, you should go by and make a big job, go to full fight. You play the game up to 25-23.
Wow.
The first prize was Pigeons.
The first prize?
Pigeons. Pigeons.
Wow.
Oh.
504.
504.
Wow.
For Atomics. He said, Musa, you man calling, you fight for this one.
Wow.
Start fighting. The hall is crowded and you know table tennis that time is so popular.
Yeah.
That time we get so big.
That's right.
They play with football, we play table tennis, everybody do their own.
And you had the support of people like MQ and Abiola.
Yes, everybody.
The sport icon.
Everybody.
Once those kind of people left,
no.
Sports start going down.
Sport is even though Nigeria soccer is down. Not talking for that sport. Football can be down.
How much more? How much more than
that? That's true.
But let me ask you though, have you ever played Shekou Touré?
Yeah, I played Shekou Touré several times. Several times, not one time, not two, I never lost to him. But they did fine. Because when you play with them, people have that belief. Because I want to be a champion. I don't care whether the government give me a racket, no help. I use my allowance. When we travel, they give us money. So people will be doing shopping, I'll be doing shopping. And I have rockets, extra rubber. I use all my money. Because if you have a good player,
that's right. So, do you think your style and Shegu is similar? I know they say he counterloops a lot.
Yeah, he do a lot of stuff. He do a lot of stuff. And when the cutting starting stage, counterloop is too risky. You have to time everything. The counterloop is just a question of when you try to bring person out of position, you lose balance, and you pop the ball off, then you turn before the ball comes. Because I always do everything before the ball comes. It's just like in the game, you have to make up your mind what to do. No question of I want to do. Yeah, exactly. When I play with this guy, I just know what to do. If I want to win first, I'll win. But I'm a person that by now, which is not so want to beat anybody in every team.
That's
just having fun. That's
But what I was going to ask you is that now, at your age, you and also you want to pass the legacy of yours to other children and the next generation.
Yeah.
What are the tools that you will tell us? Because at your age, I mean, if you can tell us as well, what do you do every day? Do you run? Do you lift weights? What are you?
Yeah, you know, the problem with New York is that you guys here, when I arrived yesterday, I woke up and noticed that you guys go to shopping, try. You guys go to pharmacy, you guys go to McDonald's, you drive. But in New York, we don't drive too much. We have a car, but we don't drive. Why? Because if you park, no parking. And parking is so expensive. And they tow your car immediately. So what do we do? We walk in. We walk.
So when do you drive to?
I drive on Sundays with the family. Yeah, Sunday parking is free.
Okay.
Monday to Saturday is not free.
So Monday to Saturday, you won't be walking.
The car is only for Sunday.
Wow.
Because you can't park anywhere, like tickets, even to $5. Over the 2 hours.
Wow.
And if they tow your car, you got to pay for the tow, you have to pay for the store at the end of the day, pieces of it. So we are living in New York, we know that, so we stay away from that.
Interesting.
So why call this place now? You park free.
Yes.
I got to go outside. I got to go outside. Your car is gone.
Interesting. Do you still lift weights?
I lift weights, I do sit up. I do like 50 pounds.
every day.
And you eat, I mean, you watch what you did.
No, I eat anything. I eat a lot.
You eat late.
I eat a lot. No question of I eat when I'm feeling hungry. No question of sleep. No, I'm serious. I'm
but you're constantly exercising. I was telling you, just watching you talking down there, you were doing your body all the time.
Exactly. Every part of your body is working. Because the problem is that in this country, if you want to breathe, it's very easy. But if you want to listen to yourself, listen, I don't care about the necessary. Because here, we only think of how we're going to make money, but we don't think about the health. Or you look at us, we play together, we are together for taxi, I keep on telling her,
that's right, that's what will come with that kind of weight. Diabetes, all kinds of problems.
Listen, I work in a place that I've been paying insurance for the past 12 years. I'm not going to say because it's not going to stay in my body. It's not going to stay in my body. When I finish playing, I'm not just going to pick up the exercise. That I have to do before I take a shower.
Every day.
People want to look at this and they want to take for a look. You have to go there. Yes, sir. You have to go like this. Look. But you don't forget that. That one will make you warm up. That one will make you cheer. That will go to the table. Your brother is looking at you. Oh, this guy is good. So all these things are very important in this sport.
And you don't eat all this sugar and all this sweet
food. I'm honest with you. I hate it.
Wow.
I swear to God. I was just like, I do a lot of exercise. I eat in our own life. I eat any job for me. Would you come to me in New York to my club? It's why because I'm not happy with you. I push out to play. I push out to give her mercy. I push out to do a lot of stuff after 15 minutes running. I can't do this.
Which other Nigerian players do you have in New York? I know they had a Bassi.
Yeah, we have a Bassi.
Bassi is no more right there. So he went to Nigeria.
Yeah, that is Jamie.
Oh, yeah.
The player that
I know. Cash
is a good guy.
But which other high level
players? They used to come from Europe, like in the summer. They used to come to my house. They stay in my house. I used to accommodate a lot of people who come from Europe.
Oh, very good.
But even though when their wife was pregnant, I used to invite them to my house. They have a baby, they stay in 6 months. I do a lot of stuff for people. I'm honest with you. But if anybody wants to come to the United States, I was the one that wrote the petition.
Wow.
People who have 10 years here and the wife.
Wow.
So when your wife pregnant, is a mentor. Because the luck we have, we love that, we let your wife come and have the kids.